we begin directly with yes. Yes, so we begin directly with one of the numerical on friction. Okay, so that is related to wedge. The problem looks quite simple. It is simple though. So let us see. So what do you see here? What all blocks and what it is intended to do, it exactly is like this. So the top force, this P force which is coming from the top, it is trying to get into this space, right? And what if it gets inside this, what will happen? What will happen? Yes. Yes, yes. Because this distance is more, if it gets here, it will push this much by this particular distance, right? So it will go this way. So accordingly we will draw free body diagram, and what is given, angle of friction is 15 degree, means mu is equal to tan 15 degree. This is quite clear. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to determine the force P which is required to start sliding. Even if it goes at a higher pace or with a higher force, okay, higher effort, still it will move, but I just have to start sliding. That means everything that is to be considered, it is within this zone, okay, just start sliding, that is just crosses the kinetic static friction barrier, okay. So let us begin. How will we start? We'll start drawing the free body diagram first. So when I see the bottom block, this block number 2 which is here, okay, so that is shown here. So what all forces that are acting? First of all, this weight that is acting from the top, that will always be there. This is a force which was acting, it was given in the question itself, so it acts like this. So these two are quite simple and well understood, I suppose. Then comes this one and this one. So let us look that carefully, which direction it will be, how it is inclined, and all that. Okay, so this block, this is the block, okay, this block is sliding on top of this, going, trying to go downwards. So what force will come to this block downward? Downward force, if you agree, okay, because this is trying to get in, this will impend a force which is vertical like this. So friction force on this block will be like this, but for this block it will try to resist it, like, so definitely it will act like this on this block, whereas in this block friction force is downward. So that comes downward. So if friction force is like this, okay, there must be some interaction force which is like this, okay. So effectively what will happen, the force that comes on this block from the first block will be in this direction, so resultant force that is in this direction, so that is something like this. So R2 is inclined like this. So normal force and the friction force generates this resultant force R2, and where is it directed? It is directed at an angle, that is angle of friction, okay. So that is why it is 15 degree, okay. Hope you got this part of it.
Yes, sir.
Later on don't tell me to come back to this again. Yes, so friction force that acts on block 2 due to block 1 is downward. Understood? Whosoever has asked should keep telling yes, yes, yes. Okay, so they should acknowledge. Okay, now force that comes on this block, reaction force due to this block, block 1 on block 2, is like this. Friction force is like this, reaction force, that is the interaction force between those two blocks, is something like this. Okay, this is the interaction force acting on this, on block 2 from block 1. Okay, so resultant friction force will be like this. Clear? And how is that inclined? It is inclined always with respect to n by angle of friction. Okay, so if you extend it this side, it comes to be angle of friction that was given as 15 degrees. So, this is your R2. You agree? Yes. Yes. Yes, because the friction force is given, no? Already it is given. It has just started sliding. It is not necessary. That is the maximum case that we are looking at. That is the maximum force. If it can handle that maximum force, it will handle all the other forces. So, we will consider the maximum force. That is what? That is due to the static friction limit. Got it? That is due to this friction. And no kinetic friction is given. So, we will consider the limiting case. If we are able to through that force, we are through forever. Right? The block will start moving. So, we started considering the maximum force that comes here. It is not given. No other friction forces are given. Only one friction is given, that is 15 degree angle of inclination of that. Okay. So, only this force is given. So, we assume it remains there. Let us say this surface has crossed that limit first. It reached to that limit and it remained there. Is it not? Then this force, this one, crossed that threshold. So, this will also attain its maximum value, and that is the maximum one. It will remain there also. So, both of them ultimately reaches to the maximum friction force. After that, you don't have any other friction force given. Okay, so, we'll assume that both reaches to that maximum value and sliding just is about to start. Again, it has not started. Okay, so that is why. So, this is about block 2 on this surface. Okay, let us talk about another surface now. Okay, we will see the other surface now. How is that? Yes, please.
Sir, in the block, this is the block that actually runs, can we draw the intuition in the R1 direction?
No, don't draw by intuition. You already know the things where it is about to move. Now that you already know the things, don't use your intuitions. Use your knowledge now. You know if friction is in this direction, R2 will be inclined from the vertical towards that direction. Okay, you always use your knowledge. So, again, talking about the bottom one, bottom surface, this is the block, this is the surface. So, surface applies a friction force along this direction, right? Along this direction on this block. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And how about this normal force that comes on this? It is vertically upward. It is vertically upward. Okay, so your R2 will be something like this. R1, sorry. Resultant force. So, this is your normal force. This is your frictional force. So, this will be your R, and this is inclined at an angle. Again, 15 degree. Right? 15 degree from the vertical. This is about to slip. This probably has reached its maximum limit, but this has just reached there and it is about to slip. Okay, so this is also 15 degree. So, R1 is at 15 degree, R2 is 15 degree, like this. So, directions are well known now. Okay, this is known. Now, everything becomes very, very simple. For this block, you start evaluating the vertical force and equate that to 0. Use your equilibrium thing. Okay, so how it will go? R1 cos 45 degree, rest is just trigonometric projections. Okay, So R1 cos 15 degrees, that means this projection is equal to 200, okay, directed opposite side definitely. Yes, a component of this will also come, and that is towards which direction? It is like this, yes, downward. So R2 sin 15 degree plus 200 is equal to R1 cos 15 degree. So that is your vertical balance, okay. So you get first equation that relates R1 and R2 through some values, okay, through some values. Okay, this is equation number 1. When you consider a second equation, that will be due to the horizontal force balance. So it should be component of this like this, component of this will be something like this. So this plus this plus this should be equal to 0. Sum of all the forces should be equal to 0, or forces acting towards this should be equal to this side force. So that is how it is done, and this also will give you a relation between R1 and R2. Okay, and now what I have done, I have substituted R1 from here to this place. This R1 goes to this place. Okay, so that is where we are. We exactly have inserted that. So now R2 cos 15 degree, this value from here, and sin 15 degree plus 50. So finally we get R2 something like this. So you got R2 coefficient for this may be given. It may be different for both the surfaces also. If at all that is there, take this and as that value. This is just as a note I have put. Friction over here, it is 15 degree for both. It can be different for both the surfaces. If at all it is there, it will be given in the question. Now talking about the top one. Okay, this figure. Over here, how your forces will be? Firstly, friction, talk about friction on this surface, on this surface. So because it is trying to move in this direction, friction will be in this direction, right? Friction will be in this direction. And yes, and then normal force will be like this, that makes resultant force like this, that is inclined at 15 degree because of angle of friction, because of angle of friction, note it. Okay, now what about this force? This will remain as it is. Third force that is acting also is, now this is the normal direction, normal to the surface. Okay, so this friction again will act along this direction, friction force between this and this, clear? So friction force will be like this, again normal will be something like this, clear? Normal. So resultant force will be inclined at an angle 15 degree from the normal. So if this is normal, 15 degree from the normal is R3, this one, okay, clear? And what is this 15 degree? This is the, yes, inclination of that surface, quite true. So that is what, it is little bit confusing maybe, 15 degree for both it looks like, but actually both 15 comes from different place. This 15, because normal is inclined at an angle 15 degree from horizontal, and this 15 because of this resultant force due to normal and friction will be along 15 degree from the normal. So effectively it is 30 degree. Okay, so now everything is quite trivial. Now if you have understood the directions and their values, okay, so now things are very very simple. Just equate the horizontal component, equate to 0 using the free body diagram. So it is this for the first one. Okay, you just substitute the value which has come, 115.54, that we arrived earlier from our previous result, is it not? This was there, 115.54, this is what comes here, and you quickly can obtain R3 as this. So R3 is extracted out, R2 was done earlier. So if you again evaluate the vertical forces and equate that to 0 for equilibrium, then P should equal to the component of this along vertical direction, component of this along vertical direction should equal to this. Okay, so this is there and P comes out to be this. So hope this is quite easy. You can do this, you can do this also using vector triangle. Okay, using vector triangle means you have first force P and R3, okay, and you have R2. You can use A by sin A, B by sin B and C by sin C. So that also should take you to the same place. So this also has three equations for three unknowns. You can quickly obtain them. So using this rule also you can do this. Okay, that is known as a vector balance for a triangle. Okay, so over here again in the earlier vector triangle also you can formulate in the same way. But this place you cannot apply vector triangle because you have four number of forces. Yes. Okay. But at least in this location you can easily apply it. Okay. So that is what is suggested. You try doing this as a homework. Okay. So now let us get back to a problem that is again self-locking. Again, you don't lock yourself to this. Take things very, very gradual way. Okay, and I'll try to do my best. Okay, let us see. So a wedge is split into logs, okay, into logs using a axe. Maybe this is an axe that gets into this wedge, the first figure that I showed you. Yes, so this is trying to split this off. Okay, okay, now this wedge has a cone angle. This is the half section angle as alpha by 2 that is given. Okay, that we are assuming also. Determine the maximum angle alpha of the wedge so that it remains embedded in the log. That means it should not come out once P is removed. So once P is removed, this wedge should get into that and remain there. It should not slip off due to the reaction forces. These are the two reaction forces which are there. Okay, so let us try and find it out. Okay, how that will relate all the forces which are here. Okay, can we do it? Okay, so yes. Okay, so horizontal force equated to 0. Why? Because there is a balance. It is not coming out, it is not moving. So all the forces in this vector triangle, this reaction force, hope this direction is quite clear. This is your normal, this is your normal. So this is your angle of friction. So R will be at an angle of friction. Why along this, why not like this on the other side of it? Where is the direction of friction direction? Yes, yes, very good. So this is the reaction force. Okay, so effectively if it is trying to come out or it is trying to get in first, if you are applying a force from external, okay, this P, that means it is trying to get in. So that is why friction forces are like this. Okay, because there is external force. So this is the first scenario. Okay, when it is trying to get in and it is tending to zero when we remove it. Okay, so friction forces are like this. So this is like this. So all forces are clear. So now you just have to take projection and equate them to equal to 0. Okay, so then P is equal to component of this along horizontal direction, component of this along horizontal direction. That makes 2r sine phi plus alpha by 2. Is it clear? It will be like this. Okay, it will be like this. So this is there, that is the horizontal component. Now going to the next. So in order to fix it to the block, okay, what should be minimum? This P force should be minimum in order to hold this in place. So you have to minimize this, okay, you have to minimize this holding force because it has to get embedded into this block, okay. So what you should do, you can do it this way, you just use maxima minima theorem, okay. Then del P by del alpha is the variable, that is what you want to find out, okay, that is what was asked in the question, okay. So equate this to 0. Now what you get is, so if you do this, you will get something like this. Hope you agree.
Yes, sir.
This is equal to 0 and this is equal to 90 degree pi by 2. There are many solution, but the first one you will take, okay, in the first quadrant only, okay. So that is there, so 90 degrees and finally this and this, okay. So this is first solution when alpha is 180 degree minus 2 phi, okay. So this is one, okay. Going to the next, minus where were we? We were till here, yes, 180 minus 2 pi. If you take sin a of this, okay, sin a of this, you can still relate it as this. If you take sin a of this and expand it, so alternatively you can relate it this way, alpha should be almost 2 times of phi because this is some wild angle which is getting here. Oh, and that is not possible, that is not possible, okay. If at all it is 15 degree, if at all it is 15 degree, so it comes out to be 30, that means it is almost 150 degree, which is very, very huge. That means if alpha is 15 degree, alpha by 2, so it makes it like this, okay, 150 degree, which is not possible. So this probably is the second solution. We want to get the first solution of the same inequality, that is, so that is why I again took sin a on both sides and expanded it to get something in the first quadrant itself, okay. So that is why alpha is equal to 2 phi is the only solution which is feasible for this, okay. So this is a self-locking condition, okay. So we'll talk about again the problem that we encountered yesterday, okay. Can we do that again? So that is why I quickly finished two numericals so that we don't come back to this, rather we finished this friction thing and we'll come back to earlier problem that we were there, okay. So now I have a whiteboard with me, okay. So this is something that I wanted to do yesterday also, so let us start now.